So what was a killer 6-inch figure, the Death Watch Mandalorian, we now get in the Vintage Collection line, and it's no different. It's absolutely fantastic. It's a really good sculpt and build. Take a look at the card art here. First of all, we've got Star Wars The Mandalorian on the card art there. Death Watch Mandalorian, even though this guy is basically a two-stripe Death Watch Mandalorian, which I'll talk about in a minute, because there is a one and a three, I think, from watching The Mandalorian show. You briefly see the other versions in there. I think Funko have done some variations on that too. But very nice cards. Still on that relatively thin cardstock, which is a bit of a shame when the Marvel retro figures are getting such a good cardstock, but they have promised that some is coming. On the back, most of these figures, I think I've reviewed some of them, or at least most of them, in the Vintage Collection. This is a VC-219, if you're keeping track at this point of this now. Nearly, I don't know, 15, 20, coming up towards 20-year collection that we've had going. It's been a hell of a collection to try and keep even some of them, never mind all of them, and all lots of don't stick it up your nose stuff on the back of the packaging. It appears to be a completely brand new figure, and I should mention I've got mine at Darkside Toys, link to buy it from them in the description below the video. And I think they still have stock of this guy, so at the time of doing this, get in there if you have not. What a great figure, really just beautifully done. Look, I'm a sucker because it's a Mandalorian to begin with. But in terms of proportions, in terms of paint, in terms of structure, they've hit all the notes here. Everything is really, really good. Backpack looks fantastic, looks really good. It's got a nice detailed trim around it. On the rockets, there's silver paint. Even got little pegs to plug in some potential jet thrusters, which I believe will fit from the recent Boba Fett that I just reviewed, the Tatooine Boba Fett. So you could have a blast effect, much like I've done on my 6-inch Mando here. As you can see, I've applied them from the old Boba Fett Return of the Jedi figure, the Black Series figure. So there's a bit of extensibility, which is nice, that Hasbro have thought about and planned for, which is kind of cool. We get a good holster there, working holster for that smaller pistol in nicer detail. And the rifle, the larger rifle, very obviously accurate to the 6-inch version as well. Looks pretty good. No extra paint or anything on it, but so be it. We do get a little bit of paint, a little bit of decor and detail on the smaller Mandalorian pistol, which I believe is repacked from the previous figures from Sabine? What am I on? Bo-Katan. And the other trio of Mandalorians who appear, they're all using this same weapon, which is fine, as to be expected. Got some little silver darts going on there in the gauntlet on the forearm. We've got the little symbol, the little bat-like symbol. Some scratches, some wearing, some weathering, and the two stripes, as I mentioned, not the one or the three. The blue on the helmet's a kind of mixture of tones, but they appear to have got it spot on too, as I tried to bring in, which is nice. Now, when I looked at the Boba the other day when I did a review, Boba Fett Tatooine with the Boba Fett Black Series, I think it was the Throne Room version I made, it seems like the Vintage Collection and the Black Series team did not speak or did not share Pantones, because they were very, very off the colours. Definitely a little different here, but much closer and much more complementary to the two that you don't generally notice it too much, but it appears they've shared reasonably the right colours. Maybe the differences in plastic make an impact to the way it's picked up and or size, I don't know, but ultimately the blues and the colouring across the ranges is nice. It's not super duper close, but close enough. I think what you'll also get to see here is this armour will be reused for Axe Wolves. I've not got him yet in the Vintage Collection, but he is on the way. Which was annoyingly an exclusive. Anyway, everything of exclusive. So I think that colour is a little bit more towards his tone. So you'll see that chest piece reused again. We've got that kind of purplish underwash, which is again is pretty accurate to the Black Series figure as well. So again, we're keeping the two looking together and good. And again, you get some scrapes and scratches and a little bit of weathering here and there, but you know, nice touches on the boots and little touches of silver here, and it just adds a little bit of interest to the figure and kind of sparks it up a little rather than just being all flat in one colour. They've done a pretty good job. For a 4-inch figure, this is pretty damn good. And I believe, yep, it is removable. So if you wanted to, you could have some variance in the designs. And troop build. Sadly, no removable helmet. It is just a ball socket up the top there. We do have a working range finder, which is kind of nice. Usual kind of articulation up at the top of the arms, a small ball joint up there. It is a little bit limited because of the kind of armor under there to get that under, so you're not getting great posing on that one. You've got a double joint, well, it's a single joint, but it looks and acts like a double joint because it's quite a high rise on the arm. Down to wrists, which swivel and go back and forth too. You can see the little joins there. Ab crunch, it's okay. Pretty reasonable. There is no, I don't think, waist swivel. Is that, well, yes, there is actually. My apologies, there is a waist swivel. Very hard to see, but it is in there underneath the ab crunch. Pegs up at the top of the legs, thigh swivel down to single joints at the knees, although they act like doubles because they're pretty high. We don't have a boot cut there. No boot cut. Rocking ankles. And actually pretty generous pickles. Pretty awesome. Pretty good. A good army builder. Good colouring. Good scale. Everything feels right. Doesn't feel old and reused and kind of, you know, mold degradation or kind of retapping into. At one point they kept remaking Boba Fett's and just the most awful old 2002 like style molds and sculpts. And so it's nice and refreshing to see a well-proportioned Mandalorian. Looks good, solid, compliments its big brother. What's not to like? It's a Mandalorian. Go out there and get some. Link in the description below for Darkside Toys and let us know what you think about this guy. But I'm loving them. See you for more soon.